गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग।
सर कैन यू चेक द फाइल आई सेंट यू बाय मेल?
ओके, जस्ट जस्ट गिव मी मिनट, आई विल डाउनलोड इट। This was the reference file downloaded. Hello, this is based for high poly, right? I believe.
Yes, sir.
This is based for high poly. Like you are going to import this into ZBrush and sculpt it, right?
Yes, sir. So what I did for the high poly is I separated all the shells according to the smoothing groups. Then they become poly islands in ZBrush. Then I just used polish. And polish by features.
So, make it smooth and clean.
Yeah.
Okay.
Otherwise, it was coming out like faceted or something.
Yeah.
I didn't add any supporting loops or anything. I just did Dynamesh and.
Okay. If you do Dynamesh, supporting loops are not required.
Yes.
Okay, this is the cartridge. This thing. So those details still yet to we're going to add in ZBrush, right? I believe.
Yes, sir. I was waiting for you to show us how to create the alphas and all.
Yes.
Then
yes.
I will start it.
Yes, of course. So we'll do that today only because we're supposed to start alphas and all. So we'll do that. So base wise, this looks fine only. I guess one thing is missing. This is a small cylindrical.
Yeah, yes, here. Yes, sir, yes. Sir. Those some sides are missing.
Sides are missing. Yes, that's like I guess for targeting, na? Like they
yes.
use this one and this one. Okay, yeah, that thing is missing. Okay,
the screws and all also, sir. The yeah. screws will be like in high poly or low poly?
Depending upon the size, like this one is pretty decently big. This one we have to make. And if there is any other screw, I really can't see, like maybe, I don't know.
Yes, sir, just those two.
But just those two, they are pretty big, so this is something we have to make. In low poly also, in high poly also. If anything smaller than this, that is something we can do it directly into substance. Substance
Sir,
have.
and this, suppose this one in the magazine, in the above reference,
Magazine,
the magazine there is a cut kind of thing. This will be high poly, yeah?
This will be high poly, only high poly.
Okay, sir.
And I can see there are like screws, small nuts here to hold the
Sir.
design. So the all these things can be your high poly only. No need to
Okay.
keep in low poly. Let's see. Yeah, these two small tiny things. Like this kind of small dent and everything will do it in high poly. Okay,
Okay.
let's do it. Do this one only. So we left it there, and now we have to add all these designs. So for that, we have to create alphas, and then we will like design this thing. So for that, let's see. Open in Photoshop and open reference as well. So here now I can see all these designs. So here I can see this pattern. So what I'll do is I'll just take any one of the pattern half. As this is going to tile. Control J, Control T. Just drag this ruler. Control and push it down. Push it down. Make it straight first. And make sure it's perfectly 100% straight. Clean this thing. So here also you can see it's not perfectly straight. Okay, so to make the, because this is a symmetrical design. So first thing first, convert this into a black and white. Control shift U will become black and white. And I can see there's a lot of noise here. So I now have to trace it out and create this shape. So let's use pen tool. So we can see there's a depth here and this is slightly embossed. So easiest thing will be I'll create only half. My rubber band is not visible. It's straight on. Only half side. I'll flip rest of it. So it will give me a very clear shape. So here corners you can see slightly highlighted. That means slightly embossed and slightly smooth. So before doing all this detailing, I'll generate the basic shapes first. Now. Don't get like confused by the center dark line. That is basically reflection. Basic shape I can see slightly uneven, so I'll just make it little even and remove this one. Okay, now the side one. Basic shape, and then you have this design. Now close this one. Okay, this is push it down slightly. Now start adding details. This part is this one. Okay, not required. This one. Control J, Control T, flip horizontally and shift and move. And select these two, Control E, merge. So now it will become one single solid shape. So corners are dark, that means there is a depth. Right, so what I can do, I can just fill this entire thing with black and hide this image. So this is my basic shape. So corners are dark, I have this black line already and the edges are slightly smooth. So I will use all these effects we have seen. Inner shadow, outer shadow, all these things are there. So let's use drop shadow. I really can't see anything changing here. Distance is zero. So one more thing, I need to move it up. Control shift bracket, move it up. Drop shadow, now you can see the shadow. That shadow is not important because it's for this part we already will have shadow, so I'll remove it. Inner shadow, direction I can add from whichever direction I want. Size, if I make it zero and increase the distance. You get this nice soft edges. I can scroll, like reduce, increase, and see. Soften it. So for this will work. This will give you a small soft bend. Now, V, Control, click on this, right click, and see this shape. of this. I need this same like shadow. This time inner shadow. So you can see it's everywhere. I want only the border. So for that, I can go to this contour, and you can see there are a lot of presets are there. I can use that. That should work. Not use global. Global is basically, if you use this light, it will align with according to all the layers. All the layers using the same effect, it will align with that. So I can remove that. Distance is zero. Should be like this, it should be inverted. That means you need to use this one. Change it, so corners become slightly dark. Opacity, if I want increase, decrease. Make it nicely rounded shape. This is also added to duplicate. Control J, T, right click, horizontal. Select both of them, control E. Inner shadow, double. And now I have to check the outline. There is a small gap. That's why it's creating that in between line. So it will make sure they touch each other and there is no gaps. So it will create a perfect shape. Now this one, B. I can copy this effect, copy layer attributes and paste it on this one, paste. Oh, it's layer style, yes. Copy layer style, paste layer style. Yes, I got this effect. Paste the style, so get this effect. So this one I have to modify slightly. This is like more rounded. So I guess I need to increase the distance. Make it a little softer. And corner should be a little darker. Do that. And for this, I need shadow also here. Drop shadow. Light shadow. Now let's say all of them, control E. Everything merged together. So you can see if you merge everything together, it becomes like this. Undo. So what I have to do is except the last one. It, this is also changing it because changing the layer style. So I have to select all of them, right click, rasterize, merge, nothing will change now. Control J, P, flip. So you can see it's not centrally aligned perfectly. So I have to make sure centrally aligned perfectly, merge down. So my basic shape is ready and perfectly symmetrical. That is something I need to keep in mind. So once my shape is ready, crop, just crop this one, only this much, enter, and now you can save it as a PSD, it will work. And I feel it's way too pixelated, so to increase the size, let's make it 512. Slightly smoother. It will be a little blurry, but at least it will work. Otherwise, it will create pixels. Save as desktop alpha underscore 01. Oh. Alpha 01. The JPEG or PSD both works. So PSD have more resolution. So I'll be using PSD. Now I'll go to my ZBrush. So let's see where is my reference. So this one is here. Isolate. Open symmetry, which is not required anymore. Max to max, I can use front and back or like left, right. So I need to create this design here. So I'll check, okay, this area. So the easiest part will be, like easiest way, if I mask this section, like this, isolate this, only this section, control W. So it will create a separate poly group. So control shift, click outside. You can see the entire model. Shift F, you can see it's a separate poly group now. So I can always modify this thing very easily. Similarly, I'll just simply create those poly group. Now only. Control W. So I created multiple poly groups so that I can create those designs for those designs very easily. Now I can isolate these sections, or if I want, I can split the model also. So control shift. So let's split the model first. That will make my, because if you separate your model in multiple parts, it becomes, especially for high poly, it becomes easy to control it and modify it. I'll go to subtool, split, group split. So now everything becomes separate. Yeah, this one. And shift F, you can see it's pretty low poly. So what I can do, control, I can either remesh this thing to get the clean shape. And I can see the elongated polygons. Okay, let's see, remesh. Like remesh, you can see now clean geometry, because this is just a base. Top of it, I'm going to create all these shapes. So let's see this. I can see this is a small issue. I just make it smooth and clean. Oh, no. This crisp line is fine. Polish too much, which is fine. Remesh again. You do remesh multiple times, this will become really clean. Now, all the divisions are pretty clean and nice. Control D, 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 multiple times. So now I got that alpha. So there are two ways of using it. either I can convert that into a brush and use it, or I can use the alpha directly here. So standard brush, F, drag rectangle, I can use freehand also. Like drag rectangle, I'll import my brush here. So you can create this thing. So you can see edges are vanished. So reduce the offset, focal shift, and I can create this thing very easily directly on that surface. This is one technique where we with the help of alpha will create the design. This is one way of doing it. Like I can do multiple things one by one. This is one way. And this one more way, I can use freehand. Like if freehand, I can draw it like this. You can see it's not very nice, creating this issue. So what I can do here is go to stroke, and we have modifiers, and there's something called roll. It will basically roll the brush one, another one, but it's creating multiple brushes with. So I have to fix that also. Roll distance, I can control like how it's going to roll. That's too much. One was fine. And I can use lazy mouse. The track back works. One more thing, where is my radius? I can increase so that. But you can see it's again creating this line of this thing. So it becomes very difficult for me to control. If I use this, I can draw it one more time and place it nicely wherever, like properly align and place it. But this is a tedious task, and perfection will, to create it perfectly, it will take a lot of time because you have to manually fix all those overlapping, like any issues. It's really difficult task, and plus you have to like understand this thing, like the distance between each and every design, and then assume it and then draw those things. So, but this is like really time consuming process. So with this, you can definitely do it, but it's a very slow and time consuming. But personally, what I prefer it to create a geometry and then use it. So how to create a geometry? So select your alpha first, like in alpha here, and go to alpha. There's something called two mesh. If you click on this, it will instantly create a mesh out of it. Click on this. And you can see it create that shape in a geometry. By default, the intensity is way too high. You can reduce intensity, make it a little more subtle. You see the exact shape of whatever you have created in Photoshop, exact same thing. And rotate and keep it like this. So this design you want to create, and it's something like very, I have to please this design. So let's see, like the thickness slightly, control shift, all the depth, all the background is gone, and then I'll go to modify topology, delete hidden. Now it's just this with all these gaps. So once this shape is ready, I'll keep it in this angle, top to like this, rotated this angle. Go to brush, create brush, create insert mesh, new. You'll see it become an insert mesh. Now I want to use this and draw on my shape. So let's see. So I have to go to my back to my model. Solo. So for this, if I want, I can undo everything because now it's a low poly model. If I want, I can make it delete this and this design I want to create. So I'll switch on stroke curve mode. Okay, I just press shift and click again. See, it creates that shape on the surface directly. And if I want, I can definitely modify it. You can see. So undo it. That means I need a line here in the center. Line means basically a poly group. Center, control W, two polygroups, click, drag, hold shift. So it will snap to that polygroup, that edge, and generate that design and click again. So you can see it's flipped. That means I have to draw it in a different direction. Still showing in wrong direction. Okay, I'll go back to this. Is one thing like I never like understood properly, like why I'm not able to rotate this. Alpha brush, create again. I just changed the direction because it was creating issue. Stroke curve mode. I can switch it on. Shift. And click again. So if you click again, you can see it get this shape perfectly. Only thing, this point. So I can draw it like this. As line, but this edges are not snapping. Control W only, let's check. Okay, stroke, curve mode switch off. Okay. this is like one way I can create this thing like this and align all the corners by pulling, pushing and fix this thing. But this will take again little time and it won't be accurate because I have to manually fix it. Like anything manual will create problem, will be issues. You can see, I can convert this into a brush, I convert this into alpha and do it. And I could have used alpha brush. If I use alpha brush, let's see. It should work perfectly. It's okay, anyways. I just reduced it. I just undoed everything. So now for this section, I need I need that pattern here. So what I'll do is reduce the UV, shift F and check. This is pretty low poly. So what I'll do is I'll just export only this section by this border. My Max is open. Import desktop. Visible poly, reset from ZBrush, import. Yeah, this is my mesh. Unwrap UV, unwrap, open editor. So you can see everything is flat. So I need to unwrap this. I forgot to switch. So all these lines become perfectly straight and clean. So here, to make it like easier for me, collapse. But this is just a slant angle. Delete only this. Same, only less number of polygons. So now I can make it straight and clean very easily. Or I can overlap them. That also works perfectly. So I just overlapped like, roughly, not perfect, it's not perfect. Make it perfect. That extra point, those extra points, no need. I can delete those things. Lead. Delete. Make it straight, clean. Okay. Sorry, now I got almost everything perfectly aligned. Not 100% perfect, but like roughly aligned. Only thing I have to focus is this upper side and base side should be aligned perfectly. So align them nicely. If they are roughly aligned, that will also work easily. Now pull it down and pull it here up and scale it slightly. It's become almost straight. The reason why I did this is if I apply this U texture here now, that alpha we have created, if I drag drop it here, you can see it fits into this design very easily. Only thing is it's need to tile. So I'll go to M material. Select any one of them. I pick this texture. I can see this texture is here. The tile I have 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I tile it 4 by 4, or 4 by 1. If I tile 4 by 1, I guess I tile 5 by 1. Yes. So it will fit to this shape perfectly without any problem. So this is the UV tiling I need. So either I tile the texture, let's keep it 1, 1, that will be easy for me. And I'll tile the UV. I need that pattern basically. So select everything. Align it nicely. All the corners, everything aligned. UV have extended. This UV is nothing to do with a low poly. This is just for low poly to convert this into this thing into high poly. Collapse everything. And we use turbo so that it doesn't change any shape. I can keep it like this and then export selected back to same desktop. OBJ border, override that. So now this one have UV. I'll go back to ZBrush, this mesh without changing anything. Just click on import, click that model. Import it will say this change in topology and all this thing have changed anything in high resolution. We may might lose, so we haven't modified anything in high poly. Just press yes and import it. Oh, okay, it crashed. Is already there in this thing, isolate. Okay, if this import creating problem, I can go to ZPlug, subtool master, multi append, and append this thing here. Done. And this will come here down last. This thing, this one I can delete now. That's not required. And this is my low poly with UV. Isolate. Now I need to create this pattern here. So I can just simply import that design here very easily in two ways. I can use displacement, go to displacement, but to apply displacement, you need to switch on your texture. So click on new texture, it will create a white texture. Go to displacement and pick that PSD you have created, that design. And intensity may be 0.2 or something. Why it's flipped? Oh, this texture has to flip. Okay, with ZBrush, everything flips basically. Your texture and everything flips. So alpha, I need to flip. Go to alpha. I need that alpha. And I can see the alpha here. I can vertically flip this and this place I can use this one. So now its direction is correct. It's just giving me a preview of the model, whatever displacement it's going to create. I can use this and 0.2, 0.1, whatever I want, whenever I feel like it's decent. And make sure you have decent amount of polygons for that. Subdivide, maybe 1 million, 2 million. Basic shape. Once you're happy with this, apply displacement. So here you can see it's pretty intense, very huge. So I'll just change this to intensity by 0.001. Very low. Maybe a little higher, 0.002. Slightly stronger. You can see your design is instantly ready. But displacement is a very easy process. With the help of this, we can definitely create all this thing. It makes our life easier. Like for this kind of specific design and all, I prefer this technique because it gives me very a good result. And now it's a geometry. So I can go ahead and sculpt on that again. I can modify things very easily. So similarly, I'll create this pattern again in Photoshop, unwrap that, bring it here and place it here. So it will create this design without any problem, without any issue. And I'll get very clean, neat shape. Yes, there are few things, the center, that line you can see, that is something I have to modify in ZBrush, within ZBrush. So to create alphas, there are multiple ways. You can use a drag rectangle. I suppose it's a small part. Like suppose this is only one section I have to sculpt, then I can drag it. But if I have to create, rotate and play, like create this kind of pattern, in that case, either I use a brush or I'll use an unwrap method so that my shape is perfect, accurate number of count of the shape and everything is correct. So those things I need to keep in mind and create it. And like this, we'll have to generate all the shapes, all the design we see in our model. Like you can see, we have tons of design here, and there's a small designs here. So all this design also we have to create, trace it out, or there are a lot of alphas available online. You can search for it. Most probably you'll be able to find something similar, and then you can create this thing, and then we'll generate all this thing on our surface and create it. Let's quickly. And the shape, okay. Present and present. So try this thing out. I'll show you many other process also to use alpha and all. There are a lot of processes are there, a lot of different techniques are there. I'll show those things also. So you can try this thing out, this alpha thing. So if it works for you, it's good. If it doesn't work, then we'll try some other technique also. Okay.
Sir,
Yes.
For my models, this technique will be very difficult to do because there are so many like cylindrical kind of shapes.
So for your model, it will be very easy. Okay, I'll show that in a on a different surface that you will understand. No problem. I'll explain this thing again in a different way. So specifically for your model.
Okay.
Okay then, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Yeah.
Bye, sir. Thank you.
Welcome.